Hi, welcome to MooMooMath. Today we're going to look at circles and we're going to look at segments associated with those circles. So we've got several segments associated with circles. The first one that everyone should be familiar with is from the center to the edge. That is a radius. Okay, the second one is a segment that goes all the way through the center of the circle, and that one is a diameter. And the ratio of radius to diameter is a 1 to 2 ratio. So if the radius is 5, the diameter would be 10. It's twice the length. You've also got what we call a chord. I didn't draw that, so let's go over here and draw a chord. A chord is just a segment whose endpoints lie in the circle, but it doesn't go through the center like a diameter. That one is just a chord. Okay, so now let's look at a couple situations with chords. Okay, here's the first one. Let's say we have two chords and they intersect. And to find one of these lengths, it's a cool little formula. You just take A times B, or you take the segment and the two pieces, and let's say this is C and D, and you find their product. So you take one segment, A, B, is equal to the product of C times D. And that will give you those segments. And I'll do an example of one of those in a moment. Okay, here's another one. Okay, let's say you have a circle and you have two chords. So we have a chord here. Let's call this chord AB. And we're going to call this other chord CD. If both of these chords are equidistant, so from the center of the circle to that actual chord, if those distances are the same, we've got right angles. And then we also know that it cuts these chords into two congruent parts. So you might know that AB is 10. Well, what is, let's say, CE? What would this segment be? Well, we know this whole chord would also be 10, so that segment would be 5. And that's how those work. They're pretty simple. Okay, the next one would be what we call a secant-secant situation. Okay, a secant is a segment that goes through the circle and partially on the outside. So we have two secants here, and we are going to label these parts A, B, C, and D. Those are secant segments, as we call them. So we're going to take A times A plus B, and we're going to set that equal to C times C plus D. In other words, you take the exterior segment times the whole segment, and the exterior segment times the whole segment, and set them equal to each other. And we'll do an example of that in a moment. Okay, the next one is a tangent and a secant. Okay, tangent secant works actually similar to a secant secant. Okay, I'll call this secant tangent, because a tangent is just a line that touches the circle in one place. Okay, for this segment, let's call this X, and this A, and this B. Okay, you treat the secant segment just like you did this one. You take the exterior times the whole thing. So you're going to have A times A plus B, and you're going to set it equal to this tangent squared, so X squared. And that's the formula for that one. Okay, and then the very last one of these is the tangent-tangent. So you have an exterior point, and you draw a line of tangency to the circle on both sides. This one's so simple. These two segments are congruent to each other because they're touching the circle from an exterior point. And then the other nice thing is there's a right angle. So from the center to that tangent point of tangency, you have right angles. And you can do all kinds of cool things with right triangles. I also like to call that one the party hat rule. So you can draw a little party hat, and you can see those two, the hat would have to be congruent on both sides. Now let's look at a couple quick examples. Okay, let's do an example of a chord. Okay, we have two chords. So let's say this segment is 3, this segment is 4, and this segment is 2, and we don't know this longer one. Okay, based on the chord, we're just going to take 2 times x and set it equal to 3 times 4. So we get 2x is equal to 12, and x is 6. That means this secant segment is 6. Now let's look at one that is a secant-secant. Okay, so let's draw a secant-secant. Let's say this is 3, this is 5, this is 2, and this is x. Okay, so this one we take the outside times the whole thing. So we're going to take 3 times 3 plus 5 equals 2 times x plus 2. So you're going to add those together to get the whole secant segment. So we're going to have 3 times 8, which is 24, and that's equal to 2x plus 4, which is, let's just bring that down, subtract 4 from both sides. So we have 20 equals 2x, so x is 10. So that means this segment right here is 10. Okay, so that's how that one works. Now let's look at a secant tangent. So here's our circle. We have a tangent segment and then a secant. Let's say that this is 4 and this is 12, and we don't know our tangent segment. Okay, the secant segment, you treat the same. You take 4 times the whole thing, which is 4 plus 12, and that's equal to the tangent segment squared. So we're going to have 4 times 16, which is x squared, and 4 times 16 is 64. So that means x is equal to, because you take the square root of both sides, 8. It wouldn't be negative 8 because you can't have a segment that's a negative value. Okay, so that's a secant tangent. And let's look at a party hat rule. Okay, if you have a point out here, and let's say you know this is 2x, and you know this is 3x minus 5, you would then set those equal to each other. So 2x is equal to 3x minus 5. Subtract 3x, so negative x equals negative 5, so x is equal to, whoops, can't quite see that, x is equal to 5, so that means the segment right here would be 2 times 5, or 10, and then over here this would be 3 times 5 minus 5, which is also 10, so each one of these secant segments would be congruent to each other. So there you go, those are the segments associated with circles.